Well, we're joined now by Fiona Miller, Cherie Blair's former advisor, and from Belgrade by Navina Bridgen. She's a blogger at Westminster Wives. Her husband's the Conservative MP, Andrew Bridgen, which is probably relevant in this, although I wouldn't normally start with that. Navina, if I can come to you, the Wives of Westminster sounds like some sort of soft porn film. I'm wondering what the idea was behind the website.
Well, I don't agree with that. I'm an opera singer and I'm an artist, and also I'm a wife of a politician, and I found myself in a different role than that I was living before, as an artist before marrying a politician. And rather I like it or not, I'm part of his life and his job, as every wife is really, or partner for that sake. What I wanted with this platform that I created, digital platform, is to open the conversation, global conversation, rather than closed conversation behind closed doors, share my experience really with the world, not the voters really, but with the world, and to give the empowerment to women.
Can I ask you, Navina, then, I hear what you're saying. Do you like being brought into his world, you know, as the wife of an MP, or would you prefer to say, it's nothing to do with me, you know, you get on with your job? How do you feel?
It's a given role, really, because, you know, when you vote for a politician, family behind the politician is also part of the turbulence or dynamics of political life that is happening. And also, you know, being a politician and a family person, that also, how they say, affects the family. So, like it or not, you're part of it. Some people can choose to be behind the scenes, and some can choose to be more like involved.
Okay.
But definitely they are present in, you know, even if they say they don't, they are.
Let me bring in Fiona, because you know what it's like. Your whole family must have been consumed. Alistair Campbell, Fiona Miller, Tony Blair, Cherie Blair. You were consumed as a sort of partners in this, weren't you?
I think so, but I think it was a different era then. I do think that Cherie Blair came along at a particular moment, and she was very different to anything that had gone before. So there was interest in her, and that had to be managed. And therefore, there was a, you know, her media role had to be managed. My reaction seeing the papers on Sunday was that here's a group of rather dull men that nobody's very interested in, and they're looking for something to make them more interesting, so they're going to push their wives out there. I don't think Cherie sought the limelight in that sort of way. I think this is being used, and I think the public probably felt they were being played a bit by it, because it was a bit too obvious, wasn't it?
And do you think the women candidates won't do that in the same way?
Well, I think the really interesting thing in your opening remarks was, do we need to know the partners of these wives, partners of these politicians? I think we do need to know about Philip May, actually, because he's apparently the biggest influence on her, and she takes a lot of advice for him, and he's advising her about Brexit. And yet we know absolutely nothing about him. So you've got to ask, well, is that because he's a man? People don't care where he buys his underwear or who cuts his hair. Whereas with the women, it still provides this sort of fluffy exterior that the media like to focus on. Clothes, hair, you know, children,
Navina,
your kitchen.
Why do you think that the women don't bring in their partners or, you know, significant others in the same way?
I certainly cannot speak for them, but I think that is more common to see wives. I don't know. I think it's just the tradition, you know, in an old-fashioned way, as someone would say. I agree with your guest, and I think that public is entitled to know, and that's absolutely fine. I think that politicians, sorry, something went wrong.
I'll bring in Fiona on that one, because Navina's talking about tradition in the old-fashioned way. Yeah. Now, I guess if you're appealing to the Tory base, yes, and this is clearly all about your Tory base, the stability and the family and all the rest of it is exactly
especially
the
when you're
thing
up against Boris Johnson, who's got, let's face it, a sort of colourful, slightly chaotic.
Do you think that's why they're doing
this? So that might be one reason why they're doing it. But no, I think it was a very good way to get a big colour spread in the magazines that would have been not of much interest without the kitchen and the wife and the cup of coffee and the fluff.
So are you saying that actually it's electorally sensible?
Yeah. Navina.
I would like to add What I actually think it's the wrong here is the way how it's presented, because it's what old fashioned is about, this message that is put, that people are putting across, is that the message is always filtered and it's always a perfect picture.
Yeah.
And that's a problem because we do not live in 1950s anymore.
Singer.
And that's what I'm speaking on my platform
singer.
About.
Sorry? I think what's sad about it is these women are defined.
As we'd love to see chaos as much as anything.
No, and also we'd like to know what they do in their lives that when they're not just looking after the kids.
Some of the wives,
you're an opera singer. You could be blogging about being an opera singer. I'd be really interested in that rather than being the wife.
Well, I'm speaking about all the issues, you know, that that I'm experiencing, you know, from being shushed at the dinner table over Brexit talks by senior politicians to, you know, racism or gender equality and equal pay and feminism and all the issues that really concerns me personally. I can speak from my own experience, but also that concerns other wives and other women around the globe.
I don't want to shush either of you. I hate that part of my job, but we've run out of time. Thank you both very much indeed.
Thank
Thanks for joining us. Let me just whiz you.